And we're not going live this time. Hi, Besma. Good to see you. You can open your videos, or at least try to. Okay, so we could see everybody, see who's here today. I think by now you must be able to recognize each other since you've had a chance to have meetings together. Let me just make sure that everybody is able to do that. Okay, so today what we're going to do is we're going to have two meetings, one here on Zoom, and then we're going to go over to Go Brunch to see what that feels like as attendees, since you'll be attendees here and there, and then maybe you can compare what it feels like for your students to be on a platform. Okay, let me just make sure that everybody's able to show their videos. If you're having problems showing your videos, let me know in the chat, because sometimes when you disable or stop somebody's video, you can't get, they can't get their videos back, which is kind of unfortunate. I think as you learn more about Zoom and these other platforms, you'll see that they're not perfect. You know, sometimes we think that we're not perfect, but actually the systems are not perfect. And learning about some of their disadvantages and shortcomings is a good way to understand that technology is definitely not perfect. It's far from it. I have tried a lot of different kinds of live online platforms, and I haven't found the perfect one yet. I'm still waiting for the one that suits all of my needs as a teacher, because none of them right now are perfect. So let me see. Does anybody want their videos up there and they're not able to? Let me know in the chat. I want to check to see. Oh, okay, Pablo. All right, who else said the host? Okay, Pablo, thank you. And Vijay, okay, thank you. All right, so it's true. Okay, I was just testing. Sorry, I tested on you. I was just testing to see if it's possible to get your video back when somebody asks you to stop it. And I guess you're not. So it's a problem, because if you want your students to stop their videos and then you want them to start their videos again, they're not going to be able to do that, which is terrible. And I don't even know if I can do it. Let me try Pablo. Okay, I can do that. Can you raise your hand? It makes it easier. Try raising your hand if you can't get your video, because the hosts, Besma, I can see you. If you can't get your video. It's so good to see you guys. You have no idea how nice it is to see everyone. Okay, so there's a hands up if you can find it. There's a hands up under more. If you go into the chat, I think it's under the chat. Yeah, under the chat, you'll find under, just above more, actually, you'll see it'll say yes, and it'll say no, and then you can say go slower, go faster, and then under more it has, so I don't see anybody's hands up. Oh, I see. Okay, Anna. So Anna, don't you have, oh, okay. So I asked you to start your video. Anybody else needs me to help them with a video? So Anna, it looks like you don't want to start it. Let's see if anybody else is having problems. I'm looking. Madhavi, you don't have a webcam, so you don't have a problem. All right. So as you can see, if you have a lot of participants, it's not easy to manage. It takes time. and not everybody's patient. Our young students are not very patient. They're not like teachers. So it's not always a good thing. All right. So this is our section. I don't call it a week because we're not following a week, but more or less this course is 8 weeks, give or take. So in week, or in this section, Go Brunch, it's basically the same thing as you did with Zoom. Okay, so what did you do on Zoom? First of all, you tried out the system on your own and you created 3 video tutorials, but you can do 1 video tutorial for Go Brunch. You go into Screencast-O-Matic, you open it up, and then you go to Go Brunch, you create an account, you show us how you schedule a meeting by yourself. You do that, and that's the first, that's the first task. And the task is here, video tutorials on Go Brunch, just like you did for Zoom. Okay, any questions about the first task of this section? Raise your hand. You can raise your physical hand too. There's a question, Pablo. Okay, what's the question? Let me unmute you. There. Hi there.
Go Brunch. I mean, I clicked on Go Brunch on Moodle. How do I create an account? I'm not sure.
Oh, well, that's what you're going to show us, how to do that. And if you have any problems, we're going to see your problems. Your problems are really important because your students are going to have similar problems. So it's good. So you're going to explore. What you're going to do is you're going to go into Go Brunch.
I did. I clicked on it. It's white instead of blue background.
It has a white background.
Yeah, you know, I'm at the Moodle page.
Oh no!
I click on.
You need to leave the Moodle page in order to go to Go Brunch. Okay, there should be a link here somewhere. You go to Google. You write down Go Brunch.
Okay.
It's G O, and then I see you clicked over here. Okay, I see where you clicked. GoBrunch, and then
.com.
But don't do anything now because you're going to show us how you. Okay. No, what I'm saying is that when you do it, first of all, turn Screencast-O-Matic on so you could show us the process. The first time you go in, what you experience, what it's like, and the reason there are a few reasons why you're doing it. One of the reasons you're doing it is to experience what your students will experience. Okay, what does it feel like to go into an unknown place for the first time, create an account? Was the process easy? And that's how you're going to evaluate all these live online sessions. Was the process easy? Was it user-friendly? Where did you have problems? So as you go through it and show us the process, you'll also learn whether it's easy or not, what are some of the problems. That's the only way we learn, by actually discovering it for the first time. And then the second time, it might be easier. All right, so that's the first thing you're going to do. You're going to create video tutorials. You can create 3 or you can create 1, showing us how you get an account on Go Brunch, how you schedule a class. And then when you schedule a class, what are some of the things that you see? What does the class have? And then you'll learn how different Go Brunch is. It's really different from Zoom. But it has advantages. One of the advantages is that it's free for up to 500 attendees. That's a huge advantage. But it has 2 venues. One is webinars and one is meetings. You can't have a lot of people in the meetings, only in the webinars, which is opposite from Zoom. Zoom costs money for the webinars and it's free for the meetings. So, you know, the terminology is also different. So that's the first task. The second task is teamwork. You're going to be discussing the same as you did with Zoom, and you can be using the same presentations if you like, or you can try new presentations. You'll be creating presentations and presenting them once you discuss with your team how you're doing and the time. And then this is the second task. The second task is an individual task. You will be recording your section of the team webinar on Go Brunch. So you create a team webinar and then you record only your part. Now that's tricky. And you may have to record the whole thing and then edit. And you can edit on Screencast-O-Matic. And if you're using my account, it'll be free. Everything will be free. And you get all the pros if you join through my, and if you don't know how to join my Screencast-O-Matic, let me know. You don't have to pay anything. Okay, and still get, I created a test here. I'll be talking about another possible free for 100 people live online class called Congrea. All right, so any questions about the tasks for this section called Go Brunch? Are there any questions? Let me check if there are any questions. I want to stick to the time because, yeah, we have enough time. So I'm looking for questions. Let's see. If you have a question, you can raise your hand. Oh, okay, Besma, let me unmute you. Go ahead.
Hello. Do the pupils, that is our pupils, do they have to join Go Brunch to get the live class on Go Brunch?
That's an excellent question. Okay, because our students like to get accounts, especially if we're talking about K-12 and young university students, they hate getting, I don't know if your students, but I know my students hate getting accounts. They don't like it. They want to just go in and that's it. So yes, they do. They have to create accounts. There are, and you'll learn about them, other live online virtual classes where they don't have to get accounts. They just click on the link and they're in. But yes, they have to create accounts. Any other questions? Okay, let me see if I can see everybody because I don't see all of you for some reason. Because it's I'm screen sharing, so show any other questions. I'm going to go through like this. Any other? Okay, great. Yes, Peter, go ahead.
I've created the Go Brunch. Could you check if it's running right? Look for my own. I've done it. And I've added some of the participants. Laura, Maddie, and Rivera. I've added them.
Okay, great. So don't forget to show us the process on screen using Screencast-O-Matic. So don't do anything unless it's like having your video with you, your camera crew. Okay, your Screencast-O-Matic is has to be with you all the time so you can screen share and you don't have to waste time. So whatever you do, don't worry about it. Take Screencast-O-Matic and show us what you're doing. Any other questions? I'm going through here.
No question.
You've got your video up. Okay, I don't see any other questions. Okay, Peter, can you unmute your mic if I didn't mute it? Okay, all right. So if there aren't any questions, oh, control your camera. Requested to control my camera. You want to control my camera? You can do that on Zoom, Deepa. But I'm going to decline, okay? Because I don't think I want to be controlled or I want my camera controlled. All right. So let's go to, if there aren't any questions, we're going to go to Go Brunch. Okay, here we go. All right, so this is Go Brunch. Did I share the link with you? I hope not. Did I share the link with you? No, I didn't. Okay, good for me. All right, because I want you to be surprised. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Okay, this is Go Brunch. How many of you have actually gone in there to see what it's like? It's okay. How many of you have explored it? Okay, let me know in the chat this time. Okay, I'll check. How many of you started exploring it because you were curious, which is fine. No, okay. All right, that's okay. But don't forget to take your camera with you to take Screencast-O-Matic as you go. Okay, good. That's why it's good. Okay, so I am going to leave the room. Notice what happens. I was in my room. So this is my account. Okay, that's my account. Let me stop my camera. Okay. So you get an account, which is really, really easy. And this is what you will look like. Notice there's a lobby, and the lobby is really interesting. This is, it's more like a campus. It's like a university campus, a school, but it's more like a university, actually. You have a lobby where people can wait in the lobby. Let's see, is there a question? I saw the chat jumping. Can't see Go Brunch. Cannot see, only Moodle. That's okay. Thank you for letting me know, because I paused. This happens sometimes. Tell me when you see it. Okay, you should be able to see it now. Okay, thank you for your response. Now, this is really important. Sometimes when you play around with a tool, the floating tool on Zoom, you may by mistake disable the screen sharing. You don't stop it, but you disable it. And that can cause problems for you and your students, especially if your students are polite and they don't let you know that they don't see anything or they see the same thing. So make sure that you watch out for that, or at least tell them in advance that they should alert you in case it happens. Oh, it happened to you too, Patricia? Yeah. So it does happen when you move the floating. It's a floating thing. And there are good things about the floating toolbar, and there's some negative things, okay? And you'll learn, you know, what you prefer and what you don't. All right. So what you have on Go Brunch is a lobby. There's my page, my account, support, and support is amazing. The man who created this, Richard Lowenthal, I believe his last name is pronounced, is always there. He usually comes to these sessions too. I'm not sure if he's not here. He will be there, I'm sure, when we get there. He also makes sure that if you schedule a class, that you give the class. He's an amazing person. I think he doesn't sleep because he's always there. There are tutorials if you'd like to see them, but I think the discovering things is sometimes better, even though we think that they're time consuming, but actually they're not. There's of course Go Brunch for Business. You know, you need to make money, you can't make everything free. So there's also a business aspect. You can learn more about it and I can sign up. Okay, so let's go into my page and see what's here. Okay, not much, which is kind of disappointing because I expected to see more. And there isn't any more. So I can go into my account and see what's here. And notice what's here. You can have, notice you can change your password at any time. You can update your general information. But, well, you'll learn about the layout, what you like and what you don't like. I have a lot of things that I'm not so sure about. Okay, so that's my account. You saw what's there. And, let's go to the main part. Now, this is the important part, and this is what you will see when you go into Go Brunch. I think this is really important. Yes, he does. Richard works for a university called, I think, Live University in South America. He's based in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. So you are at your lobby, okay? And this is where you can start a meeting. Now, notice, what's important here is that their technology, their usage of words is a bit different. They call it a meeting And a meeting on Go Brunch is limited to a very small number, while a webinar is a lot better if you want more than a few people. So let me show you the difference. A meeting is just a meeting. It's not for a lot of people. It's just a get together with your family or colleagues. It's not nothing formal. It's just like a Skype meeting. So let me go to the meeting. I don't know if you've used the toolbar on Zoom. It's also a floating toolbar. It also has limitations because it's floating. So let's go into start a meeting. So this is what you will see when you start a meeting. Okay, now you get a lot of people here, but it's just a meeting, and I'll show you the difference in a minute. Okay, so you can have up to 409. I thought it was 500, but I guess it's only 409 seats, and you decide whatever you want. And when you set it up, let's say I want 4 seats. I start the meeting, and you'll be recording this, and look what happens. People come in, they sit down, okay, and that's the meeting. Okay, I get my camera. I use USB, okay, which is the same camera I have now. You can see me over here, okay, and then I can start broadcasting. I don't have to invite people in advance. So it's kind of impromptu. I think that's probably a good thing to have, you know, you just decide on a meeting, you don't invite anybody. So let's go back out of here. Notice the tools on the left here. Okay, these are my microphones, the different tools I can mute, unmute, okay, get rid of my webcam, and let's go back. Okay, so we're going back to this part. So I want to leave this room. And I'm back here. So now I'm going to create a webinar. A webinar is different. And that's what I created for you. Because with the webinar, you could invite people. You can organize it in advance. It's more formal. So you give it a name, and you have to give it a name, and you have to give it a description. And it's, but you can try it out as a test. Okay, so let's say I want to try it as a test. You need to choose one of these. And I asked Richard if I could upload my own, because I don't... I mean, some of these are not appropriate. So I chose Vancouver because it's closest to me. But Pan Pacific Singapore, why would I want to put that image for a meeting? Okay, so I think this is kind of limited. And then you decide on a session name. You can have a few sessions within the webinar. The language, there are a few languages here that you can choose from. Okay, so you might want to do it in your language, which I think is nice. You can make it public or private. Now here with the date, it's really great. Unlike Zoom, you can add the hour and minute, and you have to actually. You have to add the date, whatever you want to choose. Let's say tomorrow, you have to add the hour. Okay, whatever, let's say 8 o'clock. You have to add the minutes, and you have to add them. If you don't add them, it lets you know that you didn't add them. And then you have to also say when you want to end the meeting. So you start at 8 o'clock, and then let's say we're going to go on to say 9 o'clock. Okay. But you have to add the minutes, or it tells you that there's something missing. It won't let you do it. Okay. And then you have to decide how many you want in advance. So let's say I want 72 seats, which is what I ordered today. Do you want to have a breakout room or not? Okay. So you can decide in advance, but you can't decide both. So with breakout rooms, you don't record this session. You have to have separate sessions for each breakout room. And you can make it publicly available. And when you want to make it publicly available, which is nice, or you can add another presenter. In this case, you can add all your friends. Okay, so you can add other presenters, your teammates, and then you create. Now notice what I didn't do here. I didn't add a local image. I need the name of the event. I need description. I need the name of the first session. In other words, it doesn't let you get away with anything. Okay, so you have to fill in everything. So make sure you do that. That's just to let you know that you have to do that. I'm going to cancel and there by going into there. All right. Now, once you do that, you can view your webinars. These are all the webinars that I've given so far on Go Brunch. You can see that I've given a few. I've tried it out. So I think I know it quite well. But, you know, there's always something new that you can pick up. The recordings appear. If you don't get the recordings, you'll see I had 127 people in one of them. You have to ask for a recording. You can upload the recording into your system. And you can also edit. I think this is today's meeting, actually. This is today. So I see 12 people have registered so far. How did that happen? I guess I did share. Okay, that was a recording. You can open up the recording like that. All right. So this is today's meeting. I called it Testing Go Brunch. So I guess I must have shared it somewhere if people joined. All right, so let's go back to our session, if I can find it. Okay, which is sometimes a problem on Zoom to find out where you are unless you stop screen sharing. All right, so let me stop screen sharing. And there, now I can see everybody. This is the best part for me. Okay, seeing everyone, wow. That's amazing. All right. So we've got 3 minutes before we go to Go Brunch. So let me get the link. Are there any questions? You can raise your hand. There are two ways of raising your hand. One in the chat box. And one by physically raising your hand. So are there any questions before we go to Go Brunch? I don't see any hands. Oh, I see two participants. You see, it's letting me know. That's what's good about Zoom. It's letting me know that two participants, I'll share the link in the chat in a second. Two participants have raised their hands. Okay, so I go into the participants to see the hand. So let me see where the hand is. If they're 49, it's going to be hard to see. Oh, there it is. Efrosini, let me unmute you. Hi there. Go ahead.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, very well, and it's so good to hear you.
Okay, well, I raised my hand about 5 minutes ago when you asked a question about whether we have, I don't know, what was it, if we have already explored Brunch. Brunch, I think.
All right, thank you. That was my excuse to hear your voice. So.
Okay, but I can now. Are we supposed to click the link to Go Brunch that you sent in the invitation in the doodle poll?
No, that was a Zoom. Actually, oh, yes, that's right. That's right. That's where I shared it. That's right. Can someone add
the link to both meetings? Zoom meeting and to Go Brunch.
That's right. That's where I sent it. See, I forgot where I had sent it. Yeah, I sent it through Doodle. That's right. Because Doodle doesn't connect with Go Brunch. It connects with Skype. It connects with Zoom. And actually, Doodle, if you schedule a meeting through Doodle, it integrates with Zoom and it'll create a class on Zoom. So Doodle creates a class on Zoom, which I think is really, really nice because, you know, it saves you the time to do it. And it does it according to the number of people that signed up. So can someone share that in the chat box? Let's see if somebody got it. Not the Zoom one. Thank you, Patricia. The one for Go Brunch. If not, I will do it. Okay, let me just pull this down. And go to Go Brunch and get the link. Okay, let's see if I can get it from here. Okay, there, I got it for you. Okay, let me share it in the chat. If I can find the chat. All right. Zoom is tricky for one simple reason. Someone, oh, you added it. Thank you. Look at all the people that added it. That's great. Thank you, Anna and Peter and Efrosini and Wilma and Madhavi. Thank you. Who else shared it? That's great. Okay, that's good because that means that you know how to do it, which is great. The way I did it is from GoBrunch. I went to my meetings and the link was there. You'll be able to discover that. Okay, so we're going to end this meeting here. Does everybody have the link? Click on it because we're going there. Okay, we're 1 minute late, which is fine. So let me end the meeting.